Well, hey guys, you should really add me on Snapchat if you're not following me already, because it's a lot of fun.
Hey guys, it's Thursday, July 21st, 2016, and we are moving out of our apartment this Sunday. So first I want to give you guys a little update on the progress. So let me go show you what we've been up to the past few days. Matthias is home. Time to get rid of the biggest headache, which is this couch. That is actually too big for this apartment. And I told you guys in another video, we had to use a sledgehammer to get this in here. So let's see if we can get it out. I don't know. We got it out. What a success. Now someone's just gotta pick it up and get this thing off of our hands. So as you guys can see, we completely emptied out our living room. We got rid of both of the couches, which is amazing. We also sold our little dining set with the four chairs. So we moved in our patio furniture, which is just this folding table. So that is our little office until we leave. So that means that there is not really anything left to move out. We just gotta throw our stuff in the suitcases and we're ready to go. So yeah, the progress is coming along nicely. We are over the hump of like the stress when the apartment looks really full and overwhelming to get rid of everything. So it is super minimal now and we're really excited. So I got some questions in the comments about how we saved up money. Again, like people are really interested in this side of the whole story, which I think is awesome because I really think anybody can do this. So I wanted to answer specifically, somebody requested that I can tell some like crazy or outrageous ways that my husband and I managed to save up money over the past few years. So I want to say the top crazy ways that we saved up money. The first thing you can do is sell your stuff. And this is a great way to get started. Sell off as much as you can. Go around your house and question everything. Do I need it? Do I use it? Go in your garage, go in your basement, go in your closet. Question absolutely everything. And if you are not using it regularly, sell it. Like sell everything. Just get rid of everything that you're not using, and it's a great way to start your savings account. Everything that you sell, put it in your savings account, and that's a great little like kickstart. Next thing that we did that some people would consider a little bit extreme is how we manage groceries. So we got very, very slim when it came to groceries. We were only buying for, I don't know, a year or a year and a half. We only bought insanely basic groceries. So this means we were basically eating buttered noodles or spaghetti every single night. And my husband took every single day to work a lunch, a bagged lunch with a peanut butter sandwich and a bag of baby carrots and sometimes like an orange. And he seriously ate peanut butter sandwiches every day for I think 6 to 8 months for lunch before he was like, I can't do it anymore. So we made it pretty far. That is a long time to go because that only costs us literally like pennies a day for lunch instead of the average people that go out and spend, I don't know, $10, $12, $15 every single day on lunch. That way he could eat, he could get all the necessary proteins or whatever, and we didn't have to spend any money. So that's a little extreme for some people. We managed to do it for about a year and a half. Now we've had to move away from that because let's be real, you can only do that for so long, but if you can do it, it's an amazing way to save money. Groceries is one of the places where we just cut back. Like, I think we've spent less than $100 a month on groceries when we were really, really like deep in the money saving mode. Next, and my most recommended thing you can do to save up a ton of money that people might think you're absolutely nuts is to get another job. So we were always working multiple jobs when we were trying to save up money, filling every single hour of the day with an additional income source. So that would mean my husband would get home from his day job and literally like run in the shower, change into his clothes, and head to the second job, to the part-time job. And if you get an extra job, don't just show up. Realize that you're there to make money and save every single bit that you make. And while you're there, if people ask you things like, can you stay late? Can you work on Saturday? Always say yes. That was one rule that we had. We were working in hospitality, so obviously the amount of effort that you put in kind of comes back in dollars. So we made a rule for ourselves that if anybody would ask us anything, we would say yes. Can you take the table? Yes. Can you stay late? Yes. Can you work on Christmas? Yes. Can you fill in the blank? We always said yes, anything to make more money, and we always saved all of it. And we did this for a very long, extended period of time. Everyone will think that you are nuts, but it's worth it. The next thing that my husband did particularly, that many people will think you are totally crazy for doing this, but if you want to save money, it is the way to go, and that comes to your education. So my husband was in college the first, I don't know, 2 years we moved over here to the United States, and we did everything possible to save money on tuition and books. So that meant we sat down, we looked at all the classes that he needs to graduate, and we made the most aggressive plan possible that all of the school counselors and everybody on earth told us not to do it, that we can't do it, but he did it. So he planned out that he can take an insane amount of classes in one semester, and he did 2 years of school in 1 year, which saved us, you know, that's $8,000 in savings right there. So if you're in school, set out an aggressive plan, you know? Don't just show up at school, really own it and realize that there's a goal, you wanna save money, so anything you can do to save money, do it. Take as many classes as possible, even if your advisors and parents and whatever people are telling you you're nuts, I think it really pays off. If you're motivated, it's totally possible. Another thing that I did that some people might consider a bit wacky is I completely stopped cutting and coloring my hair. You can see my hair, it's very long, and I did not start this because I like how it looks. I started doing this because I was sick of spending $100 on haircuts. So when I stopped cutting my hair, it just was a great way to save money, save time. I didn't have to go to get my hair cut anymore. I didn't have to go sit in a chair for a few hours and get my hair colored. I just completely let it grow, and I actually really like how it turned out. So that is a really easy way to save money. I also cut my husband's hair at home. One time it didn't work out so good, and that's okay. You learn from your mistakes and you don't do them again. So don't be worried about screwing it up because it's just hair. It grows back and you can save so much money, so it's worth it. Next thing that we did over the past 3 years in order to save up a ton of money was basically like stop buying clothes. 100% we stopped buying new clothes, and we purely started shopping at Goodwill and thrift stores, buying things used, buying things at rummage sales if it's possible, and that was just a humongous way to save money because, let's be real, we all probably have enough clothes to cover the basic needs. If you're shopping for clothes, it's probably more out of boredom or things that you want or things that you have convinced yourself that you want. So I really encourage you to stop spending your money at the mall, stop spending your money on clothes, and even if you need it, like you got a job and they say you need black pants, you don't own black pants, go to Goodwill, try to go on half off day, try to go with a coupon. They have so much clothes in those stores, I guarantee you, they'll have your size and your color, and you can spend like $3 on a pair of pants and not go to the mall and spend $50, and if they're for work anyways, it's like, you know. Last and very important thing that we did and that you can do as well is sit down and look at all of your bills and start to, again, question everything. Look at your cell phone bill. Can you lower it somehow? Look at your electricity bill. Can you lower it somehow? Is there some bill you can cut out completely, like an unnecessary insurance policy that isn't really good, or a cable bill, or do you have the wrong kind of internet? Call all those companies, try to get them lowered. If you have internet that you think is too expensive, call them, negotiate on price. You have to ask for things in this world. And a lot of the times they're willing to work with you if you threaten to close your account. That's what I find. If you say that you're gonna close it or you're gonna switch to another company, they'll definitely work with you. So if you have less bills, that means more of the money that is coming in can go into your savings account. So those were just some of the kind of crazy or weird things that we did over the past few years to save money. I really hope that you found some useful information in those tips. Thank you guys so very much for watching. I love you so much, and I'll see you very soon in the next video. Bye!